couple of weeks ago, and we are delighted to be able to welcome to the NBC family right now the host of that show. Let's hear it for Mr. Bob Hilton.
Yes, sir.
Welcome aboard, Robert.
How you doing?
I want to wish you good luck, but I have a feeling you're not going to need it because, one, you're...
And you can be a winner, just like these City Game players. Play Channel 5 City Game and win. Call now, 1-900-321-WCVB. Calls are 95 cents a minute. Players must be over 18.
For a transcript of this program, send $3 to Transcripts, Sally Jesse Raphael, 267 Broadway, New York, New York, 10007. Or call 212-227-READ.
Dr. Shaner has said one of the things you do when you are betrayed is it helps to talk it out, which is why we did the show, which is why some of these nice people contacted us. And in this sharing, we learn from each other. And I want to thank you. I feel a lot better now that we've talked. It's been a heck of a day. Thank you.
Some members of our audience will receive, and a promotional fee has been provided by...
Drake's Cakes are good as always and better than ever. You'll love the way they taste, and you'll love the way they're made. Drake's Cakes.
Paul Mitchell Professional Salon Products. Luxurious hair care and styling tools. Paul Mitchell. Your style demands it. New Arid Cream in a Tube. The first no-mess cream antiperspirant. Just squeeze it up and smooth it on. For powerful protection against wetness and odor, New Arid Cream.
I am not an actress, and this is not just a commercial. It is my true story. One night, a few months ago, I almost died. I was all alone when I slipped and fell, hitting my head against the door. I was bleeding badly. I couldn't move. I couldn't even reach the phone. The only help I had was this LifeCall pendant I wear around my neck. I pressed the button. I've fallen, and I can't get up.
We're sending help immediately.
LifeCall sent an ambulance to my door within minutes, and the paramedics rushed me to my hospital. LifeCall even told emergency room doctor...
Even higher, a plan to scrap nearly all of the expanded sales tax passed into law just last week. And a wet and wild weather forecast continues. Barry will tell us about us. Good afternoon, I'm John Henning.
And I'm Pam Moore. Join us for the noon edition of Eyewitness News, next.
Chances are... What we have here is a GE refrigerator with the takeout counter. Splendid.
That's when you need to know. You can...
You'll discover these deep door shelves. So deep, they can swallow 12 gallons of milk. In fact, nothing holds milk better. Well, almost nothing.
Now, PC. Service for the GE dealer nearest you.
Closed caption television. It puts words into your world.
New Kids on the Block, tonight, 7:30.
Now, the news of New England and the world, live from NewsCenter 5, Midday.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jim Boyd.
And I'm Susan Warnick. Topping our news today, the Massachusetts-based computer giant.
Noon edition.
Good afternoon. In the news at midday, for the first time in its history, Digital Equipment Corporation is reporting
$1 billion in the last quarter. DEC, based in Maynard, says the losses are due to restructuring charges. Company officials say there are plans to slash the workforce by
adding it to many business services and go back to a house plan.
GOP. DEC was considered among the stronger high-tech companies in Massachusetts.
Clearly, DEC will survive. They're big enough, strong enough position in the marketplace, sound financially, that they will survive.
Now, DEC officials say that they have been careful not to lay off anyone so far, but have not ruled out layoffs entirely. In fact, they say, despite the $256 million loss last quarter, DEC is showing a profit for the year. The news apparently hasn't affected the company's stock. Just moments ago, digital was up more than a half point. We'll have more on the digital story coming up tonight on NewsCenter 5 at 6. Susan?
Okay, thanks, Jim. In other news now, the House Ways and Means Committee has just unveiled a new compromise tax plan repealing almost all of the recently approved expanded sales taxes and replacing them with an even higher income tax. Here's NewsCenter 5's Kirby Perkins with live details from the State House. Kirby?
Susan, we got the proposal just moments ago, and it does indeed essentially repeal, take out of the bill, everything that they had put in terms of sales tax expansion. There are some exceptions to that.
Workforce, how do you do that without laying off thousands of employees?
Still prevent businesses of energy on calls.
Kind of gracefully push people out.
For materials, tools, fuels, and machinery used in newspapers, television stations, and radio. This is by many observers up here attributed to Senator William Bolger wanting to keep this in because of his long-running differences with the news media, especially the Boston Globe. But by far the most important aspect of this reworked tax bill is an increase in income tax. Essentially what's happened here is that everything that was done since the House passed its version, which gave us the highest income tax rate in the country, everything that's been done since then in terms of sales tax expansion has been thrown out the window. They simply couldn't get the votes for it in the House. What it means is they've gone back to giving us what amounts to the highest income tax rate in the country. Now, Democratic leaders are all meeting with Senate President William Bolger right now. We use the word leaders advisedly because we haven't been able to find many people in the House that have been willing to follow them. But they're not talking much, so instead we're going to talk to the House Minority Leader, Mr. Stephen Pierce. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. He is, by the way, a candidate for governor as well. Your view of what they've done here?
Well, I think it's incredible that after passing the largest tax bill in the state's history and finding they have a deficit, they send the tax bill back, and instead of reducing the deficit by cutting spending, they bring out an even larger tax increase. This is absolutely astonishing. This is another $140 million of increased taxes above and beyond the $1.6 billion the governor signed last week. Absolutely astounding, Kirby.
You don't think it's fiscally responsible given the fact that the budget deficit was already, there was already out of balance by $300 million?
It's not fiscally responsible to take the mismanagement mistakes of this state government and the current crop of Democratic leaders and make the working men and women of this state pay for it. No, that's not responsible.
We know you're a candidate for governor, but get yourself out of the political world for just a second and be a political analyst. Will it get through the House, the income tax increase now? It's changed so many times. What's your guess about what will happen here?
Well, I think anything can happen. I mean, there's no leadership here, and there's a great deal of confusion. I've never seen things this bad. We're going to fight it very vigorously this afternoon. I promise a good, strong, tough fight. I don't know what the outcome will be, but we're going to give it our best shot.
Thanks for stopping by. The views of Mr. Pierce on the lack of leadership up here are not just Republican views. You hear a lot of Democrats saying the same thing. Many Democrats are saying they've never seen so much confusion on Beacon Hill. We'll have more on NewsCenter 5 at 6 on this news tax package and what happens with it in the House. For now, reporting live from the State House, this is Kirby Perkins. Now back to the studio.
Okay, thank you, Kirby. Well, in New Hampshire,
to a flat 6%.
The Seabrook
News.
Railing wire and bubble gum. It's just barely holding together.
Halls is suing the Rhode Island.
The tall halls with
the reactor. NewsCenter 5's David Ropeek reports.
Of the 11 companies that own parts of Seabrook, as well as present staff and some of the people who helped build the plant. There was even a minister who used to work here.
We give you thanks and we ask your blessing on the future of this facility.
These people have put years of work and emotional energy into a place they believe in, and it is exciting for them to celebrate full power operation.
And I'm immensely proud to say just behind us right now, Seabrook Station is operating at full power.
But a handful of protesters who stood outside see Seabrook's operation differently.
I find this whole situation very depressing. I don't think the public can afford Seabrook, and I think the environmental danger is very apparent to anybody who lives in the area, and they've found no way to take care of the waste.
Even if Seabrook runs smoothly, there may yet be bumps on the road ahead. The Nuclear Regulatory Commission has just started an investigation of allegedly counterfeit parts here, sold to Seabrook by vendors claiming they were of nuclear grade, but which parts are actually alleged to be substandard. And Seabrook's opponents will be in federal court in September, arguing that the license was granted on a flawed process, that evacuation plans won't work, and that the license should be revoked. From Seabrook, David Ropeek, NewsCenter 5.
Eastern New England has been battered by a series of heavy thunderstorms over the past 24 hours, as you probably know. The storms have dumped as many as 7 inches of rain in some areas. Heavy rains are blamed for serious flooding and power outages on Cape Cod and in New Bedford and the Plymouth area yesterday. For the latest on the storms and their paths, here's meteorologist Bob Copeland. Bob?
Thank you, Susan. We have the Chatham radar up here, and this is a loop.
How fearful.
And blessed is
and ran. And now we have a new tax package going to the
showers and thunderstorms. One has been out over the ocean, but occasionally backing in over the Cape, and then another has been right up in the Boston area. You notice the western fringe of this area has made some slight eastward progress this morning, but it's still basically a line of showers and thunderstorms just coming right up the same train tracks from down around Long Island to the Boston area. And so those areas that have had some heavy rain this morning will continue to get some probably for at least this afternoon. And we're not out of the woods even after that, but we'll have a complete look at the weather a little bit later in the program. Right now, back to Jim and Susan.
Okay, thank you, Bob. Well, more bad news for America's space program. NASA officials say tests this morning show the grounded space shuttle Atlantis is still leaking.
Tax package he signed last weekend.
Had hoped to cure the problem by tightening bolts around a critical fuel line, but today's test shows that that effort didn't quite do the trick. NASA says that the continuing leaks may force now a delay in a mid-August flight that had been scheduled for Atlantis.
Well, meantime, a European space agency is celebrating success after launching an Ariane 4 rocket from a South American launch pad last night. The rocket placed two satellites in stationary orbit, one from France and one from Germany. A similar mission carrying two Japanese communication satellites ended in failure 5 months ago when the booster exploded after takeoff.
Well, still ahead here on NewsCenter 5, psychologist Dr. Tom Cottle answers your questions on Midday Call-In. You can still call him now, phone number 931-1950, and ask your question.
And we have a really happy story ahead. A Vietnamese family separated 7 years ago has a joyful reunion at Logan Airport. We'll have the details when the Midday News continues.
In August. Last night, campaigning in New York, President Bush said that he's optimistic that Republicans and Democrats can agree.
Supposed to be finished and online 9 years ago at a...
And the president also expressed confidence in Judge David Souter, his choice to fill a seat on the Supreme Court. The formal nomination goes to the Senate today. Souter is on Capitol Hill for a get-acquainted meeting with Republican senators on the Judiciary Committee. Later, he is to pay a courtesy call on the Democrats. The committee expects to begin confirmation hearings in September. The president hopes that Souter is confirmed before the High Court's next term, which begins October the 1st.
On Capitol Hill, the House of Representatives begins debate tomorrow.
We've worked a long time to put Seabrook Station in operation.
Massachusetts. Last week, the committee decided a letter of reprimand was the appropriate.
We've got a whole lot.
Ethical violations. But a ranking conservative in the House says he'll lead a fight to censure the congressman from the 4th District. That would strip Frank of his position as chairman of the Judiciary Subcommittee. House GOP Whip Newt Gingrich says the Ethics Committee recommendation of a reprimand for Frank's dealings with a male prostitute is simply not strong enough for the House of Representatives.
Censure, it seems to me, is the minimum appropriate action. That to have a Judiciary Subcommittee chairman, the author of the Ethics and Government Act, guilty of lying to or misleading a
And when news breaks, New England's most experienced teams
cannot accept.
On the Senate side, it's a day of reckoning.
We'll have the very latest wrap-up of all of today's ceremonies on News 7 at 5 and 6 for now. Jerry D'Amico, News 7 Live with the North Bureau, Seabrook, New Hampshire. Lester.
Okay, thank you very much, Jerry D'Amico, reporting live. And, of course, Jerry will have more reaction to today's festivities a little later on at News 7 at 5 and 6 o'clock. Another New England energy note for you. Word from Washington today of a delay on a decision on a natural gas pipeline leaking our energy-hungry region to Canada's rich gas fields. The Federal Energy Regulatory...
Plaintiffs claimed Philip Morris conspired to sell cigarettes to minors. But the Supreme Judicial Court found no evidence to support those claims because a third party was actually responsible for illegally selling cigarettes to minors. But the SJC did rule that the plaintiffs can pursue their claim that Philip Morris breached an implied warranty that its tobacco products were safe.
Topping our national news line this midday, Supreme Court nominee David Souter is talking.
Children at the Hellenic College Vacation Bible School are rehearsing a Greek welcome.
Found Jeffrey Randall bleeding from multiple stab wounds in front of 1810 Dorchester Avenue about 3 this morning. Police have no motive for the attack and have no suspects in the case so far. Coming up on News 7 at noon, Supreme Court nominee David Souter makes his first call on Capitol Hill. And zoo officials call off the search for Ardu, the wandering wallaby. We'll be back.
Right. He's expected to vote for the sanction this afternoon.
The first U.S. tour for the spiritual leader, who is based in Istanbul, still called Constantinople among his followers. The Church of England has a new leader, George Carey, today.
He is making his bid to return to sea. Hazelwood faces a Coast Guard hearing held to determine if he can keep his seaman's license.
He's here in the United States.
In a moment, a celebration for Seabrook, but more turbulence for Eastern Airlines.
And the space shuttle Atlantis going nowhere for now.
Again today, nearly 8 years after being separated during a daring escape from Vietnam, Van Nguyen Hoa and two of his children made it to the Boston area, but his wife and son were left behind somewhere in a crowd of people. News Center 5's Anthony Everett was there last night for their long-awaited reunion.
Can you describe it all?
Van Nguyen describes this as the biggest day of his life, bigger even than his wedding day. For more than 7 years, these pictures are all he's had to remind him of a wife and son left behind in Vietnam. Separated when the family tried to escape in a refugee boat, Van and two of the children made it and started a new life in Boston. His wife and son literally missed the boat, left behind half a world away.
I've been asking, like, my dad, is my mom coming? And my dad keep saying, soon, soon, and I never see her. And I don't really believe this day have come.
A Brookline businessman befriended Van, helped him get his first job, and when Van raised the money to send his wife a ticket to America, helped clear the channels for her arrival.
Once I met him and spoke with him and saw his difficulties and troubles, and I felt this was the time for me to come out and try to do what I could.
And tonight, the waiting finally came to an end. Separated at a midnight flight to freedom so long ago, the family finally reunited.
The first thing I saw my wife, she had to cry, and my son had to cry too, because for 7 years I don't have to see my wife and my son. So this time, you know, I'm very happy.
Really happy, yes. Yeah.
Van Nguyen became a U.S. citizen this year. Now his family is together. Asked about the future, he says he can finally look ahead. Anthony Everett, News Center 5 tonight.
We have this story just into News Center 5. Eastern Airlines and several of its top managers were indicted today on charges of falsifying aircraft maintenance records, logbooks, and other aircraft safety documents. The violations allegedly occurred at two airports between July of 1985 and October of 1989. Martin Shagrew, the court-appointed trustee who is running Eastern during bankruptcy proceedings, says the airline will not plead guilty. The announcement adds to the uncertain future for the troubled airline. It, of course, has been struggling for more than a year under federal bankruptcy protection brought on by that bitter strike.
Well, Harvard University archaeologists on a dig in Israel have made a most unusual discovery. An ancient golden calf figurine believed to represent a pagan idol. The hand-sized figurine was found in the rubble of a temple destroyed around 1550 BC. The calf is believed to be more than 3,500 years old and is the first of its kind ever on Earth. Early legends of Judaism warn against worshiping golden calves, and they are often mentioned in the Old Testament. The find could help scientists to learn more about the development of religion. Well, still ahead here on News Center 5, psychologist Tom Cottle joins us for Midday Call-In.
Meteorologist Bob Copeland will be back with a complete look at the weather for this afternoon.
And in sports, the Red Sox continued in their slump in Milwaukee last night. We'll take a look at sports, weather, Midday Call-In, all coming up after this.
Hydrogen leaks were found. Atlantis is scheduled for a...
Probably notes to merch.
Now...
Yeah. It was still us, but a million just...
Extra winter fresh.
The problems for bankrupt Eastern Airlines just got worse. Eastern and several of its top managers were indicted this morning. It is the first time criminal charges have been filed against an airline for faulty maintenance. The charges include conspiracy, fraud, falsifying records, and impeding an FAA investigation, all during a three-year period before last year's machinist strike. If found guilty, Eastern could be slapped with hefty fines, and some executives could go to prison. The man running Eastern now says that a plea bargain agreement with federal investigators simply fell apart Monday night.
To the U.S. Attorney's demand for a guilty plea to a conspiracy charge, which in our judgment would have called into question this entire airline's present superior maintenance program and all employees and managers involved in it. We cannot and will not plead guilty to violations of the law for which we find no evidence.
Both Eastern and the FAA say there is no problem now with safety regulations. The airline is already operating under bankruptcy protection, though, and losing $1 million a day since the union strike started more than a year ago.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
You haven't missed much good weather this week.
I'm telling you, I came back and it's pouring rain.
We had a report from southeastern Massachusetts of animals marching two by two looking for an ark. We're trying to trace it down. Barry will be here with the forecast when we come back on the noon edition.
What we have just rent-to-own company. This brand-name portable color TV and VCR are just
sitting on Nantucket, 70 there, 71.
Is the airline trying
to the upper 70s in inland areas.
Off just does get inside a bobbling ball by John Morzano.
Feature.
The Sophia Grand Sam's double feature has big names too. It's now playing at a store near you. Sophia.
Well, no matter where you are around here today, you're going to see some heavy rain, huh?
That's right. Well, unless you're watching from Worcester County, out there, sun's out. From there west, it's a real nice day going. So, depends a lot where you are.
What are we doing here?
What are we doing here?
Hmm.
We're trying to track these crazy storms. Yesterday, of course, it was the South Shore's turn with a good 3 to 6 inches of rain in an area from, New Bedford on up to Plymouth and Bridgewater and Taunton and on up to the South Shore around Quincy and Braintree. But today, that area has shifted a little bit, but we'll show you in detail in just a second. Right now, I want to show you the satellite loop. You can see the clouds developing out over the ocean here and heading about straight northward. And notice how they really billow up as they develop into big thunderstorms in this very tropical air mass. And with a lot of instability around, they continue to drop rain at incredibly heavy amounts in the order of 1 to 2 inches an hour. Fortunately, they move right along, so it'll rain very hard for a little bit and then slow down and stop for a while and then start raining hard again. But you can see the western half of New England, west into New York State, is looking very fine. Let's go over to the other computer. We'll slow it down and look at the latest visible. As of 11 o'clock, you can see that sharp edge on the cloud line slicing right down to about Worcester. Much of New Hampshire and Vermont getting into sunshine now, as well as western Connecticut and Massachusetts. But these storms continue to pop down here south of us and head almost straight north, north-northeast. So eastern New England looks as though it's going to stay under the gun here. Let's take a quick look at our radar and see just where the precipitation is right now. That'll show one big band extending out to about halfway between 128 and 495. And this is where the very heavy rain has been over the past couple of hours. But there's another line now from Providence extending up to the area that had the heavy rain yesterday. So there may be some heavy showers coming for you. And the Cape is about due to get nailed again with some very heavy showers and thunderstorms coming up that way. All right, let's go back to observations as of noontime. We can see Logan Airport is currently at 69 with moderate rain. If we could just take a peek at the, there we go. And here again, moderate to heavy rain reported at Blue Hill now coming down at a couple of inches an hour at times down there, as well as at Dover, Mass. The forecast for eastern New England, this afternoon, frequent showers and thunderstorms, some tropical downpours with temperatures holding in the low to mid-70s, but sunshine, scattered thunderstorms possible in western New England, highs there in the 80s. Now tonight, we expect the shower and thunderstorm area to continue here in eastern sections with some heavy downpours, 65 to 70, be muggy and foggy. Tomorrow, the rain may actually expand as a storm system south of us gets into the act, and so look for more heavy rain tomorrow, scattered thunderstorms.
It's getting heavier by the minute now, just taking many, many calls in the last 10 to 15 minutes from weather observers saying it is absolutely torrential.
The load of moisture. We've had about 2 inches of rain in 10.
It started as a one-man gruesome.
Other features here
that can be improved or managed.
Can't tell.
That's what I thought.
Right.
I mean,
thanks.
It can't possibly rain on a weekend, because I'm sure that all the rain will be down on the ground by then.
You may be right.
Considering all this that we're having. Okay, right. We take a look at sports now. Well, it took them
a thunderstorm, so this is the area that's going to be primed for this afternoon. Let's take
this his nominee for the vacant Supreme Court post, but speculation about Souter has raced ahead of the formalities. The New England jurist is on Capitol Hill today getting acquainted with the senators who will vote on his confirmation in September. So far, he has skillfully deflected any questions about his position on abortion and civil rights, but pro-choice senators plan to probe further.
If this Senate knew, or even highly suspected, even if he hadn't actually said, I will overturn Roe, I think if we actually thought that or knew that, he could not be confirmed.
This nominee will be pushed very hard on the abortion issue. And I also think he won't answer the question.
Some of the first stops this afternoon for Judge Souter, Senate Minority Leader Robert Dole, and Senate Majority Leader George Mitchell, as well as members of the Senate Judiciary Committee. Still ahead on News 7 this noon, the Red Sox go down in extra innings last night in Milwaukee. We'll have the highlights for you, but first, a look at the action on
Wall. And opening, The Promise.
It's called Arthur, and it's moving in position like that, so we'll be
So let's stop taking care of political insight.
2 hours will be critical for little Tracy. One other American undergoing similar transplants.
Custom crafted eyeglasses in about an hour.
In much of the eastern Massachusetts in poor drainage areas. Otherwise, sunny way out west with a couple of thunderstorms popping there. Muggy between 70 here in Boston to 84 out in the Connecticut River Valley. Showers and thunderstorms overnight. Areas of fog, 65 degrees. For tomorrow, ditto. Little change from today. More areas of flooding. And then Friday, Saturday, and Sunday still looks on the showery wet side on Friday. And Saturday gradually getting sunnier with time as we go through the weekend. Let's hope that one works out. It'll still be very muggy right into next week. Wow. Still a chance of a shower, but at least it should get sunnier by the weekend.
Well, we certainly hope so.
But at least you're brightening up our day.
At least for the moment, yes.
He says that to everybody. Let's check Wall Street. It's we get past the noon hour here. In active trading so far,
transporters like these to come in small containers with big price tags. Here's some very big news. Introducing Henry's All Natural, gourmet flavors in affordable half gallon.
That's a subordinate issue to a bigger issue, and we'll talk about that.
Workers' compensation and personal injury law is our only business. We charge no fee unless we're successful on your behalf. Anyone can call me for a free consultation, and I know of no other law firm who can say that.
Roomy, comfortable, affordable. Behold.
In this envelope, free information that tells you how easy.
Remedial training. That's not job training.
With a whole life policy. That is
fine, though, stumped by the question from a man from Plimpton who wants to know how he can gain 20 pounds. He's physically fine, but he needs to gain 20 pounds. I'm going to work on that one.
Let me know how.
Yeah. Is that
a terrible
problem?
I feel real bad for you, Mr. Plimpton.
Oh, boy.
But a person from Westwood has a question that I think you can answer. I have three kids, 7, 6, and 4. They usually sleep in our bed, and my husband sleeps in one of their beds. Do you think this is normal?
Normal it is, in the sense that so many Americans do this. America is one of the only cultures that has this complication about having the kids sleep in bed with parents. Most other cultures, it is just a matter of course. That doesn't mean it's necessarily so great or so good. The part of this story that I don't like is, first, the ages of these kids. They should be in their own bed, I think, by now. But even more important, the part that I don't like even more, if you've got that sentence followed, is the fact that dad's being dislodged. No good. I don't like that idea. Children should not dislodge dad from bed or...
...you the important information in this envelope. And it's...
...and continues an improvement. Can't rule out a shower here and there this weekend. And just remember, some of the showers will be coming down hard in the next 24 hours. It may cause some flooding of the streets and the highways in the places where they're the heaviest. And that especially looks like southeastern...
So I lost twins through miscarriage. Now I feel guilty.
...insurance. You'll receive this handy guide...
...feel sad. And I'm scared to death to try again.
That's exactly right, Lynn. That's exactly the feelings, if I may say so, as a man that you're supposed to have. Of course you're going to feel all of those feelings, the sadness, the anger, the guilt.
I took a ride, I didn't know what I would find there. Another road where maybe I could see another kind of mine there. Ooh, did I suddenly see you? Ooh. so you. What can I be when I'm with you? I want to stay there. And if I'm true, I'll never leave.
This is a Channel 7
real to provide gold.
Five, the final score.
Whose patrons are leaving government. Just one example is the pension board.
With a budget deficit of approximately...
Action got their guy hired...
On to Detroit for a four-game series there. The Sox are a full game behind the Blue Jays in the AL East.
You got to go on vacation again because when you were here before you left, they were doing better.
The crowd couldn't help the United States basketball team last night at the Goodwill Games in Seattle. Ted Turner and Jane Fonda on hand to...
...apparent backroom deals...
First time the two countries have met in basketball since the Soviets won in the Seoul Olympics. Alonzo Mourning blocking everything in sight here. Coach K likes what he sees in the first half from the American squad. Billy Owens, the All-American from Syracuse, shows off a few moves as Team USA makes a late spurt in the first half. Then it was Mourning time. But in the end... it didn't work out. USA by three at the half. It was the Soviets the second half all the way. They hit everything they threw up. No contest at the end. United States loses 92-85. And if the Americans lose to Italy tomorrow, they will be out of the medal competition in these games. Not very, a lot of talent, but they're playing schoolyard ball against a very tough competition.
And losing. Well, we're having another last short look at the weather.
Well, get the arc ready. Lots of heavy rain close to Boston while there is sunshine west of Worcester, and this could last for the next couple of days. Be prepared. Take it slow on the roads. There'll be lots of big puddles.
Carry an umbrella. Look out the window. That's the news from here. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy the rest of today. Stay dry, and nice to have you back.
Thank you, and good day.
Oh, then Badala Vinyl will make your payments for...